Good morning, my YouTube brothers and sisters. This is April 4th. Not April Fool. This is April 4th, 2016. I am going to be heading out at least to the end of the jetty out there. I'd like to get out to one of the reefs and see if I can find a cobia or two. We'll see. It's going to be a beautiful morning. A few clouds. We'll have to see when we get out to the end of the jetty how big the waves are. Let me take this opportunity to thank a few GoFundMe donors who are helping me out in the Safe for the Whole Family Fund GoFund page. I'd like to thank Danny H, Adam M, Lev M, Justin S. I know him very well. Thank you, Justin. And Rodney B. Thank you, Rodney, for donating to my GoFundMe page. I'll put a link at the end of this video. And if you'd like your help to help me get a little bit bigger boat than this, higher gunnels, that's what I need, about that high. Keep the water from getting all over me and getting all over the equipment and everything. Be safe. Well, I might take some more people out. You never know. You never know. Anyway, I'm heading that way. Going to try to cast net me some bait right up here. Got my cast net ready. I'm going to try to cast me some bait right up here and maybe over there by the Coast Guard station. And I'll get back to you in just a little bit, I hope, with some fish. You know, guys, it's not too bad out here. I'm not feeling any wind at all, really, hardly any. Some clouds and some waves, not too bad. This is the day the Lord has made. I'm gonna rejoice and be glad in it. And really hope I catch some nice fish. I need something for the cooler. I haven't given anything to the food pantry in weeks. Giving a few fish away to some people who needed it, but not the food pantry. So let's put some fish in the cooler, triggerfish, lane snapper, anything we can keep, anything at all. All right, waiting for a bite. Well, my. This is just on a dead herring. And I was just trying to get back to the spot, because I wasn't at the spot. The old GPS trolling motor, I forgot to turn on the GPS part. Well, let's see what we got here. Oh, first fish of the day. About a 20 inch red snapper. Okay, let's move a few things out of the way and get this little circle hook right out the side of his mouth. The side of his mouth. Look at that. That's in the side of his mouth. Just like it's supposed to. Yeah, I'll let him stay in the water. Big, beautiful, about a 20 incher. They're not big enough to bend the hook. That's a good thing, folks. That's a good thing. See this? Old dead herring. Threadfin herring. Caught last week. See there? That's why they call them thread fin. Rather than throw them back, throw them out, keep them, use them the next time. If fish are hungry, they're gonna eat. Yeah. Let me go ahead and put this down. I see I've already wandered a little ways off my target again. All right. So I can get back on target. See, guys, that's what's so great about these GPS trolling motors. I am working my way. See there? Back to my spot. Turn it from here. little ways more to go. Then I'm gonna press that right there, and it keeps me right at that spot when I stop. So I can move if I want to, 20 feet to the right, 20 feet to the left. If I want to get out of the structure, I move a little bit to the right or the left or front or back. And that way, if I catch a big fish, got a chance to get him away from the structure instead of him diving right straight back down into the structure. That's why I love this GPS trolling. The Lord's been good to me and let me have that. Cost me a little bit of money, but that's just the way it goes. All right, moving ahead. Well, my first goal today, boys and girls, brothers and sisters, is to catch some bait. After I catch a bunch of bait, I'll take this sabiki off and put a regular hook on there. Oh, there's one I got. Oh, that's a little bitty baby red snapper. So I'll throw him back for sure. But I'll throw this guy right here in the live well. And a little teeny red snapper on a sabiki. Oops, gotta get him out. All right, boys and girls, New Smyrna Beach, right there. I don't know if you can see it or not. There's the lighthouse. That's Daytona. See the buildings? I don't know if you can see the buildings or not, but it's right there, Daytona. I'm within sight of land catching these big old fish. Woo-hoo! Well, I just had an enormous shark, a 7-footer, come up after my sabiki bait. I don't see him this time. Keep catching these little teeny red snappers. And I gotta let them go. Little teeny red snappers. I'm not interested in red snappers. Especially little teeny ones. Well, this was on a cut ruby tail. It probably didn't missed a big red snapper. Not huge red snapper. About the same size as last time, I think. 20 inches. Let's hope it's a mangrove. Wouldn't that be great? Or a mutton. Wouldn't that even be great? Come on. But I think it's probably the most prolific fish we have out here. Come on. Oh, uh-oh. Something came and got him. I think, yep, there's that big shark. Look at that shark. Oh man, took a big hunk out of his back. Look at that bite. Oh, shark attack. He's a goner now. He was hit too hard, I think. Well, I still gotta let him go because, you know, that's the rules. He needs about a 20 incher. There he goes. I'll bet you $1,000 he's not gonna make it down to the bottom and stay alive. Well, I moved from that spot over there where the big shark was that was eating those great big red snapper I was catching. I moved to another spot over there. Wouldn't get anything good. I moved here and wham! Something took me down in the structure, popped me off. So, big something. I got the old wire leader on now. It's about a 100-pound wire leader. Everybody been telling me, put some wire leader on. Okay, got wire leader on. Let's play with the big boys now. Come on. Come on. Oh, hey. Come on. There we go. Oh, got me off too. Yeah, I got this reel locked down. Here we go. Oh, come on. Oh, man. Come on. Oh, my gosh. What the heck was that? Come on, get it in your mouth. Oh, got it off again. Not giving up easy this time, am I? Come on, big snapper. Come and grab a. Lay it on the bottom. Yeah, lay it on the bottom there. There we go, there we go. Hurrah, rah, rah. I know, circle hooks, I know. Here we go again. This is my last grunt, and then I'm going to have to put the sabiki back on. Catch some more. Oh, hard hit, hard hit. Oh, man, I got him this time. Okay. That was a big ol'. Oh! That's a 100-pound test he broke, folks. Well, I'm trying to sabiki up me some more bait. I kept losing all my grunts. And I got a few more, and I think there's some triggers down there. I just wish one of them was big enough. This is my second one I caught, about 12 inches. A couple years ago, you could keep a 12-inch trigger, but not today. We gotta be 14. I'll get some. I'll get some. Well, let's see if I can get one of these up to the surface. This is on a dead cigar minnow. Let me get past a Goliath grouper I think lives down there. Alright, I think I got it past the structure zone. Where he can't get back in the structure on me. There's some real monsters down here, folks. I see them down there. I dropped the cams down, but as you can tell, way too wavy. Right in the lip. Right in the lip. Oops. Too far back there. Let me get these boca. Leave them in the water just for a second. Just get them ready in my dirty boat. Okay, come on. I'll measure you and let you go. All right. And when my stepsons come, I hope that they can catch one. That's about, he's about 26 inches. You hear that? Justin and Ryan, only 26 inches. I'm gonna leave this one here for you so that when you come, you guys can catch them. I can get them off of here. Yeah, I'm trying, my friend. Drop that down there before I lose it. Yep. Say ah. Say ah. Turn around. There we go. And there she goes. Say bye. Bye. All the way. Woo! Good. Come. Well, here we go again. Ooh. Catch another fish. Ooh. Oh, and lose another fish there in the pipes. I was trying with all of my might. Actually, I think I still got my bait. I still got what's left. Well, yeah, let me thread him through a little bit better and chuck him back out there. That last one actually bent the hook. Let's see if I can get this one up without a bent hook. He's trying to bend the hook. Oh, daggone it. Pop the hook. Pop the hook. Well, I got a whole grunt on here, and I think it's a 5-aught circle hook, which is not big enough for some of these big Brutuses. That's a whole grunt on here. Got bit off, I think, by a shark a minute ago. It was a nice clean bite. Wasn't any rubbing on the pipes down there. Right over there. It's all the structure. That's why if I can get one here, keep him away from that structure right in there. Wow, That's the secret. That's the magic. Boy, I tell you, it's taking me a long time to learn how to fish these reefs with all these culverts and pipes and poles, cement poles and stuff. Takes a while. Takes some skills. It's all about learning. All right, come on, boys. Something going on down there, something going on. Something big is going on, something going on. Come on up here. Let me get you up here. Come on, come on. Oh, oh man. That's so much fun. One of these days I'll get them up here. Now I just threw my line out there because this is braid. If I'd have dropped it straight down, that fish would have gone like this, got all snarly, tangled up and everything. But also, let me tell you, that's why it's so important to use just regular hooks, not stainless steel hooks, so that these fish that are breaking me off, yeah, they're big, but those hooks will rust out, golly. Those hooks will rust out in a month or two and not cause them any harm at all. But, gee, I have caught fish out here, red snapper, with stainless steel hooks in them and a long length of leader hanging out of their mouth, even with weeds and stuff hanging on it. Now, come on, guys. Just use the right kind of hooks that rust out. All right, I think this is a 5-aught circle hook. I probably need to go up to about an 8-aught because I've had some of these hooks get bent. Fish that I should have got to the boat, got off about halfway up, bent the hook off. Bent the hook. Let's see if, didn't get that one. Let's see if the hook bent. Just slipped out. Didn't bend, just slipped out. Okay, that's okay. I moved this line about 5 foot off the bottom. And if I keep this big guy from bending the hook, we'll see what he is. And if we can keep that Goliath grouper that sometimes, right here. Well, it was a red snapper. It was a red snapper. Look at that hook. What'd I tell you? Look at that hook. That's why he got off. All right. Here's my experiment. I'm tired of losing these fish because of bent hooks. I'm putting a double 5-aught circle hook on here. So let's go down there and see if we can catch something. Ooh. Sorry for the spots on the lens, folks. I need to pay better attention. This is so much fun out here, though. It's kind of hard to. I had to hit. Come on. Let something be going on down there. Let something be going on. There's something going on. We hit it, dropped it. Do it again. I need to see if my experiment works. I don't think, well, he might be big enough. Bigger than that one that just got off. I might have to go with this double hookup. Look at there. That's how you do it. A double circle hook catch right there in the side of the mouth. I might have to vent him. Her, him. But I'll let you go in just a second. I hope you can get down. He's only about 23. Where's my G hooker? Real quick. There it goes. Go on, keep going. Good. Good. I hate having to stick a hole in him to vent him. Now he'll probably live. How about that double? How about that double circle hook catch? You know, folks, see this ocean here? That's a whole lot like the Bible. If you just leave your Bible sitting on the shelf, you don't know what's going on underneath there. You got to open it up. There's a whole world inside your Bible, full of life, full of good things, full of things that'll bless you, keep you out of trouble. Open that Bible up every day. Read a little bit. Let God do the rest. He'll take care of you. Promises. Come on, let's see if the double circle hook technique works again. Got a hit. Might have gotten stung, so he might have just dropped it. I know you're hungry. Yum, yum, yum. Eat them up. Yum, 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 yum. Come on, come on. Oh, there we go. There's a hit. I think he's on there chewing. There he is. Chewing, chewing. Yum, yum, yum. Chewing, chewing, chewing. Yep. Oh, I missed him. Daggone it. They got no better. Circle hooks. I think I saved my bait though. Oop. I think I got another hit. Yeah, I got my bait. Come on, do me right. Let me see if my double circle hook technique is working. I got something going on down here. Something's going on. Come on. Hook yourself. Here we go. Here we go. There we go. Oh my gosh. What the heck have I got? Oh man. Oh. Whatever it was, it's too big for me. Oh. Well, look at there, folks. There's my double circle hook technique. I guess it kind of worked, sort of. I got a scale on there, but I got a broken circle hook. So I must only had him hooked with one. Let me put another one on, yeah. Okay. And he definitely swallowed it. If I can keep him out of the pipes, I might get this guy up. Oh gosh. Oh, this is the old double circle hook technique. Come on. There he is. I see him down there. Woo! Ah, come on. Come on back up here. I'll let you go. Yep. Another monster! And by law, we have to let him go until we get a season. So if anybody asks, why did I let the red snapper go? It's because we have to. Look at that. Double circle hook right in the side of the jaw. And they work perfect. Bye! That was fun. Thank you, Lord. Come on, show me the double circle hook technique works again. Yes, sir. Come on, you hit it. You want it? Take it. There you go, there you go. Big waves. And the old Minkota trolling motor, she's a working away like crazy. Look at there, look at there. Oh, daggone. Take it in your mouth. Eat it. Yum. Come on. There we go, there we go. He's hitting it, he's hitting it. Ooh, it might be a smaller snapper sizing up the bait. There we go, there we go. He's hitting it, taking it, taking it. Mm. Oh gosh, keep him out of the structure. I don't want to lose any double circles. Yeah. Come on up here. Who's your daddy? Come on. I think I found a secret. It's called the double circle hook technique. I won't be losing any more of these big boys. Look at there. Look at there. Right in the top of the lip. I kind of knew he wasn't a big, great big one. I kind of knew he wasn't a huge one. He's only about 22, 23. Yeah, I'll let you go. Yeah, I'll let you go. Right in the top of the loop. Goodbye, and thank you. And thank you, Lord. And thank you, fish. This is on a dead grunt. These fish are just hungry as can be down there, folks. Whew. Man. The old double circle hook technique. Yeah. I'm going to patent this. Nobody else can use it. You got to send, you got to contribute to my GoFundMe page. Save for the whole family. And then I'll let you use my double circle hook trick. Yeah, look at there. Look at there. Yabba dabba doo. Oh. Oh. In the top lip. I see one. Oh, they're both in. Oh, gosh. There is another hook in here. Look at there. A stainless steel hook, just like I was telling you about. I got me another trophy, because I'm going to get this stainless steel hook out of this big fish. Look at there. Look at there. Stainless steel. Bye. Have fun. Live long. Stainless steel circle hook. Look at there. Hadn't been in there too long. Folks, I don't use stainless steel. I'm taking this one home as a trophy. There we go. Put it right back over there. Just had a hit on this nice, lively ruby lips. Come on. Do that again. Well, I'm going to have to sabiki up me some more bait. Because I'm down to my last grunt in there. And grunt on here. That way Lee comes back. I think he's coming back. Yeah, he's coming back. I don't think he's a monster. Then again, he might be pretty good size. Yeah. If I get one up in the one of the bigger ones, then I'll measure them for you. This feels like about a 28, 27, 28er. Maybe 25. Because he is not. First, he could be sleepy. You know, I'm getting kind of tired too. Nice big one though. Look at that. Nice big red snapper. Lip hooked him with the double circle hook technique. Yes, sir. Let's see if I can get just a rough guesstimate measurement while he's in the water. Oh, about 23 to 24 inches. That's a nice meal there for a couple, two or three, maybe four people. Get back down there. Get that air bladder back in there. Way to go.